Burmese London Drum. The Bouvier de Tron Drum. The Boxer. The Paul Rasley. The Canadian Eskimo Dog. The Doberman. The German Pinscher. The Giant Schnauzer. The Great Dane. The Greenland Dog. The Hobart. The Leonberger. The Mastiff. The Neapolitan Mastiff. The Newfoundland. The Portuguese Water Dog. The Rottweiler. The Russian Black Terrier. The St. Bernard. The Siberian Husky. And finally, the Tibetan Mastiff. I hand you over now to Graham Hill for the commentary.
Thank you, David. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Well, here we are at the climax of the first day of judging here at Cruz 2006, the group judging. And this is the first of the seven groups here at Cruz, and also at all of our championship shows in the United Kingdom, the working group. The winner of this group is one of the finalists who will appear on Sunday evening in the domestic show ring, and of course will be representing the working group. The working group is made up of dogs who have been selectively bred over the centuries to assist man in a number of different tasks, such as guarding, draft dogs, and rescue dogs. Almost all of the working dogs are large, strong, and muscular animals. They are incredibly intelligent and will be trained to perform useful tasks. This group contains some of the bravest and most heroic dogs in the canine world. It is largely for these qualities that they make such excellent guard and rescue dogs, and that the working group contains some of the most popular dog breeds. There are 22 breeds represented here in the working group this evening. Following Mr. McManus' first look over the breeds, he moves to the first of the group, the Alaskan Malamute. The breed was judged today by Mrs. Zenon Thornandrews, and from her entry of 212, this male was selected as best of breed. His exhibit number is 47. Originating in the United States of America, the Alaskan Malamute was named after the Malamute Inuit Eskimos living on the Arctic coasts of western Alaska. This breed was used as a draft animal long before Europeans visited the Americas. The Alaskan Malamute. This is a powerful dog with a deep chest and outstanding stamina. Although wolf-like in appearance, the Alaskan Malamute is an affectionate dog, popular in Canada and the United States of America as a family dog. It's the Alaskan Malamute. And now we move on to the Burmese Mountain Dog. Mrs. E. Upton was the breed judge. There was an entry of 244. And this male was selected best of breed, exhibit number 348. The Burmese Mountain Dog, originating in Switzerland, is another ancient breed. The Burmese have almost disappeared in the late 1800s, but after some careful breeding and a revival in its popularity, the green was given its present name in 1908, the Vernon's Magnetron. This is a dog of striking appearance and imposing stature. The tricolour markings of his soft, silky coat add to his impressive appearance. That's the Bernese Mountain Dog. And next to be seen by Mr. McManus is the Bouvier de Flandre. This was another green judged there by Miss Zena Thorne Andrews. She received an entry of 80, from which she made his male best of green, exhibit number 473. The green originates from the Flanders area of Belgium in and around the 1600s. This robust cattle droving, cart pulling farm dog existed in a number of coats and coloured varieties until 1965, when the present standard was written. During World War I, the French Army used the Bouvier in its medical corps, and has more recently been used as a pit stop. The Bouvier de Flandre. With the exception of the Nuremberg Bouvier de Ardennes, this breed is the sole survivor of the once wide variety of Belgian Bouviers, or cattle dogs. The Belgian Shepherd Dog. The Bouvier de Flandre. Now we see the Boxer. There was an entry on 296. There were two breed judges. The dogs, Mrs. E. A. Ingram, and bitches, Mr. A. H. Brace. This dog was made best of breed, exhibit number 524. The Boxer originated in Germany in the 1850s and was first used for guarding and bull baiting. The Boxer. The breed's muscular, intimidating appearance makes it an excellent house protector. At the same time, it is an extremely gentle animal, especially with children. That's the Boxer. And now we see the Bull Mastiff. The breed received an entry of 166, from which Mrs. F.A.B. Wilson, the breed judge, selected this bitch as best of breed. Her exhibit number is 860. This is the breed that originated here in Great Britain around 1800 and was developed from 60% English Mastiff and 40% Bulldog. It was produced to act as a gamekeeper's assistant with the ability to chase and catch poachers on larger stakes. The Bull Mastiff. Naturally intelligent and observant, he is easily trained, but likes to have a reason for doing things. That's the Bull Mastiff. Now we see the Canadian Eskimo Dog. Dr. Paolo Gondino of Italy judged the breed. He made this male best of breed, exhibit number 918. Originating in Canada thousands of years ago, this dog has been the only means of transportation for the Inuit Eskimo living in what are the Nunavut and Northwest Territories of Canada. That's the Canadian Eskimo Dog. Greg is really still used instead of pulling, instead of racing. The breed adapts well to the new people and is capable of typical canine affection. But it is a breed most suitable for working. The Canadian Eskimo dog. Now we move to the Doberman. This was another breed that had two judges, one for males, Mr. G.G. Stafford, and for bitches, Ms. H.A. Jones. There was an overall entry of 302, and this male was selected best of breed, exhibit number 1010. This elegant, often affectionate breed is a classic example of the industriously successful dog breed program that took place in Germany just over 100 years ago. This is the Doberman, ladies and gentlemen. The Doberman is intelligent and firm of character, loyal and obedient. The Doberman. And here we have the German pincher. Dr. Paolo Domenico of Italy is the breed judge. And selected as male for best of breed, exhibit number 1214. As the breed name implies, it originated in Germany sometime in the 1700s. The German pincher. With its sleek, handsome looks and medium-sized build, the German pincher should be an ideal companion dog, but surprisingly, it's now an American small breed. The German pincher. And now we move on to the giant schnauzer. The breed was judged by Mrs. Patrol. There was an entry of 81. And this male was selected best of breed, exhibit number 1234. This is the largest and most powerful of the German schnauzers. This reliable dog was developed by breeders by increasing the size of the standard schnauzer. It originated around the Middle Ages and was a commonly used herding breed in southern Germany. The giant schnauzer. In the latter part of the 19th century, it became very popular as a butcher's drover and guard. When it was first exhibited in Munich in 1909, it was called the Russian bear schnauzer. Now it's the giant schnauzer. And now we see the Great Dane. There were 266 Great Danes entered here at Krufts, and Miss Jean Manning was the breed judge. From that entry, she selected this picture as best of breed, exhibit number 1424. The dignified but affectionate Great Dane is the national dog of Germany. Its origins were almost certainly traced to the dog brought to Europe by the Scythian tribes from what is now Asian Russia. The Great Dane. This breed is used as a war dog and a large mammal hunter. This breed may be used as a companion or guardian dog. The Great Dane. And now we see the Green Number Dog. Another breed judged today by Dr. Paolo Domenico of Italy. This best of breed is a male and exhibit number 1563. The ancestry of this breed can possibly be traced back to dogs accompanying people from the Siberia, well over 12,000 years ago. The Greenland dog is not as heavy as the Canadian Eskimo dog, but is often slightly taller. This is the Greenland dog. The Greenland can be used as settler, guardian, and a watchdog. Today it is used for sled racing and hunting, and in Norway and Sweden, it's become a popular hiking companion. That's the Greenland dog. And now we move on to the Hoggavard. Dr. Paolo Gardino of Italy, judge this breed. And from entry 44, selecting his picture as the breed, exhibit number 1590. This is a breed of considerable antiquity, having been known for many centuries as a guard dog, mainly of the farmyard. He hails from the Black region of Germany as the Hoggavard. He was first recognized by the German Kennel Club in 1936. The breed has only been seen in the United Kingdom in the last decade or so, and is now emerging as a truly recognizable breed as the Hoggavard. And now we see the Leonberger. There was a breed entry of 157. The breed was judged by Mrs. Anne March, and she made his male best breed. Exhibit number 1667. The Leonberger is a strikingly handsome dog. An inveterate swimmer. He has worked within the dog panel in the coldest of weathers. In the early 1800s, Alderman Penrith Essig wished to produce a dog resembling the lion on the Imperial coat of arms in the town hall of Leonberg in Germany. For Leonberg. He used the Landseer, Newfoundland, St. Bernard, Pyrenean mountain dog to create this distinguished breed. That's the Leonberg. Now we see the Mastiff. Mr. P.J. Sargent was the breed judge. And from entry of 99, I selected this bitch for best of breed, exhibit number 1779. The Mastiff existed in Great Britain 2,000 years ago and was exported to Rome as a military and fighting dog. One of the largest dogs in the world, it requires ample space to live in, and of course, large quantities of food. That's the Mastiff. The name Mastiff probably evolved in the Anglo-Saxon word Mastiff, meaning powerful. English court documents from around 1519 record the purchase of one Mastiff dog. It's probably a Mastiff. This is the Mastiff. And now we have the Neapolitan Mastiff. Mr. G. Slater was the breed judge. There was an entry of 31. And this Mr. Pitch was selected best of breed. Exhibit number 1843. The Neapolitan Mastiff was present in Campania in central Italy since ancient times, but not exhibited until 1947. The breed probably descends from the Roman fighting, war, and circus mastiffs. It's the Neapolitan Mastiff. The Roman writer Pomerant described of the perfect house of Galagog, and this could apply to his partner's breed, which was saved from extinction less than 50 years ago. That's the Neapolitan Mastiff. And now we see the Newfoundland. This is S.J. Garner was the breed judge. There was an entry of 278, from which this male was selected best for breed. His exhibit number is 1924. originating in Canada in the 1700s, he only had one of the friendliest of all the breeds. The Newfoundland was originally used in cod fisheries to pull nets and to pull boats. This is the Newfoundland. Very popular dog. The Newfoundland. Now we have the Portuguese water dog. S.J. Hammard is the breed judge. This male was selected as best of breed. He's in number 2126 from an entry of 45. As this breed's name implies, it originates in Portugal. Originated sometime in the Middle Ages. Portuguese water dog is an ancient breed. An ancient breed of fisherman's dog, used to pull nets in the water and to take messages from boat to boat. On land, it was also a useful hunter, used for hunting rabbits. That's the Portuguese water dog. The coat was originally trimmed as you see here, in a distinctive way, in order to prevent the dog's hind legs from dragging while swimming, and to protect its chest and body from thermal shock and cold water. The Portuguese water dog. And now we have the Rottweiler. Another breed of two judges. Dogs were judged by Mrs. A. Garside Neville, and bitches Mrs. M. Keenan. There was an overall breed entry of 429. From which this bitch was selected as the breed, exhibit number 2192. The Rottweiler was bred in Rottweiler, South Germany, in the 1800s. It was bred as a distinct drove-in guard dog. The breed, which is powerful in body and jaws, the Rottweiler can offer formidable protection. The Rottweiler. Rottweiler is a very active dog who needs plenty of exercise and smooth coat only needs short periods of regular good grooming to keep it in the desired shiny condition you see here. That's the Rottweiler. And now we have the Russian Black Terrier. Mr. Hans Lettinen from Finland is the breed judge. There is an entry of 56. This best of breed is a male, exhibit number 2551. This breed is a relative newcomer to the show in the United Kingdom. The breed was developed obviously in Russia. The breeding was concentrated in the Soviet Union's Red Star Army kennels in the 1940s by crossing the Giant Schnauzer, Airedale Terrier, Rottweiler, and perhaps other breeds. That's the Russian Black Terrier. The breed is used both as a companion and guard. It's covering a coarse, thick coat, providing excellent insulation in the cold climate of Russia. The Russian Black Terrier. And next we have the St. Bernard. There were 101 St. Bernards here in Crufts, and Mrs. D. Campbell judged the breed, or made his male best of breed. Exhibit number 2655. St. Bernard is arguably the most famous dog of the rescue dogs. Legend depicts this huge dog bounding through the snow in its home country of Switzerland with a small keg of brandy fastened to its collar. The dog was reputed to rescue snowbound travelers. The St. Bernard. The Bernardine Hospice has kept this family breed since the 1660s. learning in much seems to bring good draft work, boasters, hoarding abilities. Today's benevolent help is impressive muscular giant. That's the St. Bernard. And next we'll be seeing the Siberian Husky. Mr. F. A. Palmer is the green judge. There was an overall entry of 277. And Miss Hale is going to be made best of breed, exhibit number 2805. Smaller and lighter than most other breeds of Colstead dogs, the elegant Siberian Husky is agile, athletic, and a tireless worker. This is the Siberian Husky. This breed seldom barks, but engages in unusual handling and sharp wounds. The breed is dignified, gentle, and makes a pleasant companion. Also being known as the Arctic Husky, the Siberian Husky. Now we come to the final breed in the working group, and seen by Mr. Jonathan Mullis, the Tibetan Mastiff. This was another breed judged by Mr. Mark Settleman of Finland. There was an entry of 60, and his bitch was made best of breed. Her exhibit number is 2955. The Tibetan Mastiff obviously originated in Tibet many centuries ago. The Tibetan Mastiff. Going, and I could be aloof, Tibetan Mastiff is content to be one of life's observers, although it will not hesitate to defend what it feels to be its home and territory. Still uncommon and established throughout Europe, that's the Tibetan Mastiff. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we must announce having completed the individual examination of each of the 22 working breeds. Represented here at the group ring. As is usual, we'll have another quick look at each of our breed representatives. Before selecting a short list of usually between 6 and 8 breeds. Now comes the Alaskan Halibut. The giant Schnauzer. The new Newfoundland. Burning. I think that makes up our shortlist, so I'll ask you to give a warm applause as the other best of breeds lead the ring now, please. I think our judge will go and move them all again once. should be moved in a triangle, and the first we see is the Alaskan Malamute. Anderson Burnham. And now we come close to the final decisions. Once the presentations are made, I will ask our winners to do a lap of honour. So I'll follow straight on with the pastry group. So what is your number one, please? I'll ask you to show your